Here's the big question. Can we see Claire Foy as anything other than the queen? It's hard when you make such a big impression with your first role. It helps that she's stuck in so much period costuming throughout that series, because for instance, in Unsane, a movie I did not love, but I did think her performance was good, and she started to move away from the queen there. But this is a long way from the queen, by the way. So we'll see how she does. This is also Fede Alvarez's first big mainstream, big budget studio flick. So we'll also see how he does. A lot of stepping up to the plate here, both in front of and behind the camera. And then of course, there's the question as to whether or not anybody's interested in a third round of this franchise, which was never successful, particularly in either of its first two rounds. I mean, it certainly got a lot of ink, publicity-wise, and of course, the character wears a lot of ink, right? It's something that Hollywood's like, why isn't this working? Maybe the third time is the charm, as they say. Let's take a look. She looks like the queen. Let's see.
Sorry I said those things. You know how much I love you, don't you?
Lisbeth Salander doesn't know. He doesn't care.
Who the hell are you?
I'm a fan of yours.
That was pretty cool.
The CEO who beat up two prostitutes, but then got acquitted in court yesterday.
Get me down!
I'm transferring 20% of your cash to these two girls.
I'm calling down to security.
The rest, I'm transferring to your wife. Account number.
Don't!
51912.
Take your child and leave. He won't hurt you again. Mr. Chen has bankrolled your company for years. Isn't this his wife?
You bitch!
You try to contact your wife again?
That poor kid.
Or if anything unexpected should happen to her, this video will be sent to him.
Who are you?
Batman!
Are you not Lisbeth Salander, the writer of Wrongs? The girl who hurts men, who hurt women.
I'm not just hurting people who hurt other people.
I could never figure it out. Why did you help everyone?
Oh, that's cool. Fede Alvarez. You're doing a good job here. A very good job.
Can't outrun your own shadow.
Why is it this bit? Why is it spiders don't get stuck in their own webs?
That looked really, really good. She still kind of looks like the queen. I gotta tell you, I still kind of see that when I look at her, right? Especially when they show her in really good lighting. I'm like, oh my God, it's the queen. Who did that to you? Who gave you that haircut? But I think having the, I think it's Swedish, right? Swedish accent helps. And also, she's just standing in the middle of an amazing movie, right? I don't want to discredit her performance. I don't think we've seen enough of it for me to really comment on it. Because, like, this trailer is very much about Fede Alvarez, in my opinion. This whole opening setup with the wings behind her is just fantastic. It's not only visually striking, but it's clever in the setup and the trap that she sets. Because that's a weight to lift this guy up. Brilliant! It is like Batman. I said it in jest, but she actually is like Batman. And I just think this looks really stunning. It's just a you know, it's crazy. Fincher, he out-Finchered Fincher on the first American Girl with the Dragon Tattoo. This is just really gorgeous. And he's a great choice for this because Fincher's kinky, but nobody's as kinky. He's not as kinky as Fede Alvarez. He's a super kinky guy. And so this is a perfect mainstream transitional film for him. I saw a lot of faces there that seemed familiar. Is that, I can't tell if that's Jeremy Northam. Let me just look it up real fast. Let's see here. I don't believe so, but that was Lakeith Stanfield running through the office there. I thought that might be him. I'm so happy for him as well. I'm a big fan of his work. And he's also, you know, Claire Foy doesn't seem like that kinky to me. Lakeith Stanfield, Stanfield does really interesting projects he chooses, so he's a good match for this. But we'll see. We'll see if she can go here. I wanted to point out, right when she was diving into the tub, I was like, that's so cool, right? I was like, you know, this is why you didn't get paid as much for the Queen. I mean, the Crown. Because, you know, Matt Smith brought in viewership because of his Doctor Who background. And your reward was getting to be the lead in this film so that you could go on to get this kind of an opportunity. That was the situation. And I hope she got paid a decent amount for this. She should have. And that's where her salary should start to go up. And if she was smart, well, she probably signed like a 2 or 3 picture deal for this. But hopefully, you know, she can pull Lisbeth Salander and be like, I'm not, and a Jennifer Lawrence, as she did with Hunger Games, and say, I'm simply not coming back to set unless you give me a raise. How long do you want to delay the sequel? That's what Jennifer Lawrence did on Hunger Games. And it worked! What did I want to, I wanted to point out, because I'm feeling like a broken record with the first, the Wreck-It Ralph 2 trailer joke, then the Lego 2 trailer joke about, you know, men abusing women. And, you know, of course it happens. It's horrible. It's despicable. It's disgusting. And those things should be taken care of. But I think, and that's what this franchise is about. So I think we have to just chalk it up to potentially bad timing. But I would, if they're going to evolve her into a Batman type character, I would just like to see her right all kinds of wrongs, not just men who hurt women. I think it limits the audience for this. You know, you can include that to shine a light on it, but I think that there's more to be gained from having a kick-ass, you know, female vigilante whose movies make a lot of money at the box office than limiting the audience for that movie and then, you know, putting out the message that, you know, female-led action movies just don't work for the most part, which unfortunately is the takeaway, even still to this day. So, you know, there's still, it's when it works, it's always an anomaly. And we have more successes for it not to be considered an anomaly. So I'm rooting for this movie. It looked way better than I thought it did. So what do you think? There's a lot going on here. Write your thoughts down below. And of course, as always, you can check out some more videos right now.